Hallux Valgus or Bunion affects 23% of adults, 36% of elderly, especially female. It causes pain, altered lower limb bone mechanics, muscles imbalance, resulting in walking difficulties, even fall in elderly. Recent systemic review by Mota et al. 2015 included 78 studies involving nearly 500,000 subjects shows that interventions including cryocompression, exercise, manual therapy, gait training, and orthosis such as splint all show beneficial effects, including reduction in pain and improvements in function, comparable to surgical outcomes. Recent research shows that strengthening intrinsic foot muscles reduces pain and improves mobility. However, patients with bunion often find it very challenging to perform these exercises. They can't figure out how to activate them, end up with trick movements. These challenges have been overcome by using assistive modalities. The toe spread out exercise especially activates the adductor hallucis and pushing the big toe out and down. However, patients with bunion often can't separate the great toe from others. Several research reported that a single 20-minute NMES sessions improved the quality of exercise immediately. The effect lasts 2 months later. Getting the right muscles for NMES is key, especially at the foot area with small muscles in layers. Therapists can use a motor point pen to find the precise motor point for abductor hallucis. Then NMES stimulation educates patients to understand the precise activation of the IMF. The neural, active, and passive subsystems interact to produce the foot core system, which provides stability on dynamic environment. NMES works on the neural and active subsystem by waking up those sleeping intrinsic muscles, educating patients to understand the precise involuntary activation of the IMF rather than trying to figure out how to do it themselves. Several research shows that the effect of a single NMES treatment lasted 2 months, so it should be more on the neural subsystem. With NMES, they can progress to short foot exercise to have isolated contraction of the plantar intrinsic muscles. As the arch is elevated, the foot domain. Patients compensate by using mainly extrinsic muscles. After training with NMES, patients learned to use more intrinsic foot muscles, less dependent on the global muscles to create the arch. Less compensation. While manual therapy aimed it to improve the range of movement of all MTPs, functional splint helps to keep the correct alignment during walking and to improve functional exercises. The heel raise exercise aims to raise the heel off the floor while concentrating pressure inside the ball of foot. But patients with bunion often compensate by shifting the load away from the big toe area. They are unable to raise high and unable to balance. Functional split realign the big toe, so patient can train to weight bear on the big toe area, raise higher with better balance. These exercises will help to build the foundation for achieving physiological gait patterns. The body core strengthening is well known and well implemented in clinical practice for effective limbs and functional movements. This concept also applies on the foot, and its stability is responsible for better lower limb bone mechanics. According to McKeon et al. From Swiss Olympic Medical Center, intrinsic foot muscles strengthening using NMES enhances foot postural control. 4 weeks of training improve both local foot postural control as well as dynamic single leg balance. This is recommended to be integrated in any lower limb injury prevention program, or strengthening and conditioning plan for runners.